If you have gluteal tendinopathy or have been told you have hip bursitis and your pain is just not getting better, well, then you're in the right place. I'm going to go over why PRP injections are one of the best and fastest ways to reduce pain and help people get back to physical activity as quickly and as safely as possible. Let's dive right in. Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. Now, if this is the first time you're watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. Pain in the outside of the hip is incredibly common and can be difficult to treat. Doctors have a difficult time as well. We can't even come up with a consensus on how to name the condition. Initially, we told everyone they had hip bursitis, but then we realized that only a minority of people had true inflammation of the bursa at the outside of the hip. Imaging studies show that most people actually have a condition called gluteal tendinopathy. This is an overuse and overloading condition involving the gluteal muscles and tendons. Chronic stress leads to remodeling and weakening of the tendon, which causes pain at the outside of the hip. So if gluteal tendinopathy results from chronically degenerated tendon fibers, how can we start to remodel these fibers? How do we start the healing process? Well, one of the most effective ways in doing so is a targeted rehabilitation program, which involves stretches and exercises. Check out this video here for a sample exercise program to help with hip pain. Stretching helps increase mobility and range of motion, and strengthening exercises reorganizes and remodels the fibers. But many people who end up in my office have already tried that. They've done a home exercise program, they've gone through physical therapy for many months, but their pain persists and nothing is getting it better. And that's where platelet-rich plasma or PRP injections come in. Now, historically, what we gave were cortisone injections. Cortisone is a steroid. It is a very strong anti-inflammatory medication, and it is a very strong pain medication. It will help reduce pain and it will help reduce swelling. And because we thought pain in the outside of the hip was related to hip bursitis or inflammation of the bursa, it made sense to use cortisone to treat an inflammatory condition. But as we will see, the effects of cortisone are usually short-lived, usually only a few months, and that makes sense. Cortisone is like ibuprofen. It will help reduce pain, but just like ibuprofen, it will wear off. And we are also very quickly learning that cortisone injections may actually be the wrong thing to do. Many studies are coming out showing the toxicities of cortisone injections. So I really want to contrast that with PRP injections. Randomized controlled trials show that people who get PRP injections for gluteal tendinopathy show incredible results. This was a double-blinded randomized controlled trial that compared people who got a single cortisone injection to a single PRP injection. They followed how people did long-term and published results with 2 years of follow-up. And they found that the people who were randomized to a cortisone injection had maximal pain relief at 6 weeks, but then effects started to decline. But the people who got a PRP injection had sustained pain relief with lasting effects all the way out to 2 years. Interestingly, the authors allowed patients to be unblinded to their treatment group after 3 months. They anticipated that patients who were randomized into the cortisone group would not do as well, and then allowed these patients to then get a PRP injection. They found that these people, which they labeled as the crossover group, also did extremely well after they got a PRP treatment, and those effects were also sustained out to 2 years. The authors go on to conclude that among patients with chronic gluteal tendinopathy, a single PRP injection performed under ultrasound guidance results in greater improvement in pain and function than a single cortisone injection. The improvement after PRP injection is sustained at 2 years, whereas the improvement after a cortisone injection is maximal at 6 weeks and not maintained beyond 24 weeks. Now let's stop to think about why this works. PRP contains an enormous amount of your body's own platelets, and platelets are responsible for tissue healing, tissue remodeling, tissue proliferation, and in controlling pain. So what we're doing with the platelet-rich plasma injection is using your own body's capacity to control pain and to help heal tissue, concentrating it, and then injecting it under ultrasound guidance back into an area that's been degenerated or injured. And this is why many athletes choose to get a PRP injection in addition to starting a rehabilitation program. Professional and collegiate athletes are no longer getting cortisone injections. They're all getting PRP, and that's because PRP puts their bodies in the best position possible to heal quickly and safely. Many of my patients who learn about PRP injections also choose the same thing. And And if you're interested in learning more, I made another video going over answers to some of the most frequently asked questions that I get about PRP treatment. I also have an entire playlist on my channel diving into PRP and orthobiologics, so check that out if you are interested. Thanks for watching.